weeks now, there's been a chaotic breakdown in the delivery of illness benefit by the Department of Employment and Social Protection. My colleagues in the Oireachtas and in local authorities across the country have shared information with me about a succession of really challenging cases. People are left for weeks with no payment. Just this morning, a Labour councillor in Wexford spoke to a woman who is awaiting surgery. Somebody in work who's awaiting an appointment to have surgery has no money, no money to buy food, and today had to resort to get vouchers from the Society of St Vincent de Paul. Thank God they were there. People have been given minimum payments instead of their full entitlement. With one case I've dealt with, a person being offered €33 to cover 2 weeks. In another case, a woman in my own advice clinic had to wait 9 weeks for a payment. There is a social protection helpline available to members of the Oireachtas, but calls are not being effectively answered. In fact, a statement this morning by the department accepts this fact. This is causing huge difficulties for our ability as public representatives to respond to the needs of people who are waiting day by day to receive money that they're fully entitled to. The whole situation requires urgent action. I understand that there has been IT difficulties that led to delays processing forms that GPs send to certify people's unfitness to work. But the bottom line is that people off work due to illness or injury are not receiving the money that they paid for through an insurance fund and are absolutely dependent upon. It's leaving people in a dire situation. In addition, some long-standing recipients of illness benefit have found that their payments have suddenly stopped. Many people who depend solely on this payment have been left with no money whatsoever for a number of weeks, as I said, placing them in an impossible position. No adequate explanation has been provided by the department or the minister about why this has happened. The minister has claimed to have consulted with the IMO, and her department has written to all contracting GPs setting out the changes that have happened recently. The commitment by the minister to continue to consult with the IMO is not the same thing as actually stepping in to resolve the problems that dependent people are having right now. So my question, Tánaiste, is will the government clarify when it will engage directly in actions to end these delays and to ensure that all overdue payments are paid to the affected people who are in dire need of money right now?
Deputy, I'll come back to you with a detailed answer from the Minister on this. But my understanding is that the Minister is endeavouring to resolve this issue as quickly as possible. Of course, it's unacceptable that people who are relying on illness benefit are not able to get basic income that they should expect and are entitled to from the state. Whether there's IT issues here or negotiation issues in terms of concerns and delays with GP information is something that I understand the Minister is dealing with and trying to resolve. For people who are in dire need, certainly they should speak to community welfare officers, I would say, in the short term, but that isn't a sustainable answer. What's needed here is for the system to be delivering illness benefit on time in a predictable manner, so that people's incomes are arriving into homes when they're expected. So I'll come back with a more detailed answer from the Minister herself rather than giving you any further information.
What is needed? They should be doing it. The department should be doing it. These are working people who are paying their PRSI, and when the system collapses and they need, they're ill, they're awaiting an operation, they're injured, they expect that the insurance that they've paid for will ensure that they're paid what they're entitled to. And this is just not happening. And it's not happening for weeks now. I read the statement of the press release issued by the department this morning, and it was more excuses. But genuinely, the dire situation of people that I've dealt with in my own office in Wexford and in colleagues' offices across the country is a matter of urgency. I accept the Thánaiste will come back to me and tell me what has happened, but I hope that you will come back to me today and tell me when this matter will be resolved so that people will not be without the benefits that they're entitled to.
Thank you, Deputy Howland. Thánaiste.
I got a note while you were answering the question, or while you were asking further questions, Deputy, and the Department wants to reassure all customers that they will be paid the correct amount of illness benefit up to the end of their certified illness, as certified by their GP. No customer will lose out in relation to the... The Department is working to address the issues and hopes to have them resolved quickly. The Department is assigning additional staff to claim processing work to enable other experienced staff to be dedicated to call answering and dealing with customer queries. The Department recognises that due to the high level of calls to the illness benefits section, customers have not been able to reach a dedicated staff member to discuss their illness benefit claim. Additional staff are being assigned from other departmental sections and will be dedicated to the customer phone line. And Minister Doherty has sought a detailed report from the Department on how the changes to the illness benefit scheme were communicated to customers, including timelines for changes and rationale for decisions taken on timing. So, Deputy, we are working to try and resolve this issue, and we'll get it done as quickly as we can.